Well, what is important to know is really that at the subatomic level there are no separate objects, that a subatomic particle, an electron or a proton, for a physicist is not an object, but is a set of relationships that reach outward to other things. And then when you ask what are these other things, there are again sets of relationships, and you never end up with any things at all. You always end up with relationships. So it's a world of patterns, of relationships, of processes. And this is now part of a very general paradigm shift in the sciences that and in society at large, that we are no longer seeing the world as a machine made of some kind of basic building blocks. We are beginning to understand it as a network, or as networks within networks. And so that key insight that in science appeared first in physics has now appeared in biology, in medicine, in economics, in various other sciences. That's, I think, the very essence.
Process of the emergence of novelty
critical points of instability is, to me, the most important discovery of complexity theory. So this new conception of life that has emerged in the last 30 years or so in science is essentially a shift of perception from seeing the world as a machine to understanding it as a network. We have discovered that the material world is not made of some basic building blocks, but is an inseparable network of relationships. We've also discovered that the planet as a whole is a living, self-regulating system. That's the famous Gaia theory. Correspondingly, the human body is no longer seen as a machine, and the mind is no longer seen as a separate entity. But rather, we've come to realize that every living organism, every part of a living organism, every tissue in our body, every bodily organ, in fact, every single cell is a living and a cognitive system. So life and cognition are always closely interrelated. Evolution is no longer seen as a competitive struggle for existence, but rather as some kind of cooperative dance in which creativity and the emergence of novelty are the driving forces. And with the increased emphasis on relationships, patterns of organization, complexity, and so on, a whole new science of qualities is now slowly emerging. So this just is, in a nutshell, is what I call the systems view of life. And I call it the systems view of life because it requires a new kind of thinking to be understood, which is thinking in terms of relationships, in terms of patterns, in terms of context. And in science, this is known as systems thinking or systemic thinking. And this is what I've been working on over the last 30 years or so.